you know, my dear sewing friends, I truly am a believer that if you have a serger to finish the raw edges of your seams, then that's great. And if you don't have one, then that's great as well, because there truly are some of really beautiful ways how to finish the seams of your garments without using a serger. And oftentimes these seams are really beautiful and they can truly elevate your garment as well. I have five of these that I really love to use, and I would love to show these to you as well. They're easier to sew than you think. I've prepared samples with red thread so that way we can truly see what's going on. Quick demonstrations as well, so that way you can see how I sew them. So without any further ado, let's roll. Let's get started with one of the most common ways how to finish the raw edges of your seams, and that is to zigzag the edge of the fabric. And that is probably not only the most common way how to do it, but also one of the most direct substitutes to a serged edge, at least in my opinion. The other ways of finishing your seams that I'll be sharing with you today can be applied as a substitute to a serged edge. However, some of them can be only applied to a certain type of fabric or a certain type of project. So zigzagging the edge of the fabric is actually pretty universal. I'm gonna grab some of the muslin fabric for us to practice, and this is how the zigzag stitch looks when it's just a zigzag, and this is how it's going to look like on the edge of the fabric. Now this is the up close shot, and you see it's pretty narrow, it's nice and neat, and it's pretty durable as well. Garments that I've constructed using this technique as a seam finish, I still wear after 5 or 6 years. Now you can either start by sewing your seam together and then taking care of the edges, or you can take care of the edges first and then sew the seam. You can also adjust the width and the length of your stitch depending on your liking and tension as well. A lot of times I like to make the bobbin tension a little bit tighter so that way it curls up the edge as I zigzag the edge of the fabric. And from here, it's pretty straightforward. Go ahead and lower your presser foot, and here, one of the edges of the zigzag is gonna go right into the fabric, and the other edge of the zigzag right over here is actually going to fall off the fabric, creating that really nice and narrow, slightly rolled edge, just the way I like it. Now, there's another way how you can do it with just a regular zigzag stitch along the edge of the fabric, full on fabric, and after you're done, you can trim away the seam allowance after the zigzag stitch. However, I'm really not a fan of that. I really prefer it the way that I've just shared with you. Now, once both sides of your seams are completed, go ahead and place your fabric right sides together and sew with the seam allowance that you prefer. And once that is done, go ahead and pop it open. That's how it looks on the right side of the fabric. This is how it looks on the wrong side of the fabric. And now you can press your seam allowance open or to one side, depending on your project. A quick note right over here. You can also achieve very similar result with an overcast stitch performed by your sewing machine on the edge of the fabric. But I actually like zigzag stitch a lot better, although I do have an overcast stitch on my sewing machine. So I use my zigzag even though I do have an overcast stitch on my machine. But oftentimes with overcast stitch, you also need an overcast foot. And that's what I like about a zigzag stitch on the edge of the fabric, because it's pretty universal. You don't have to have anything extra, just a zigzag stitch on your sewing machine and a regular presser foot. All right, now let's talk about bias bound seams. Now this is a beautiful seam finish, and it is exceptionally great applied to those seams that might be exposed during the wear of the garment. Let's say you have a jacket that is unlined, therefore the insides of the jacket will be exposed during the wear. Finishing the seams with bias binding is a beautiful way how to make sure that those seams stay crisp, beautiful, and even be a part of the overall design of the garment. Let's go ahead and grab our muslin fabric and some bias tape as well. For our first step, we're going to place our fabric right sides together and stitch with a straight stitch. Now here, you can also complete this technique either by doing bias binding first and then sewing the seam, or by sewing the seam first and then applying bias binding. Now, here I have to say, you guys know that I absolutely love a narrow seam allowance, and I made a whole video about the benefit of narrow seam allowance, or narrower than the traditional 5/8 of an inch seam allowance. And I will leave it for you at the end of this video so that way you can click on it and take a look. Now, in these cases, when you are opting for an additional seam finish, you have to account for that extra finish. And in most cases, seam allowance has to be wider. So in this case, I'm taking 1/2 inch seam allowance. Alright, now that the seam is sewn, let's go ahead and pop it open. Now I'm gonna go ahead and press it with my finger so that way it goes a little bit faster for us. But for you guys, please do that with iron when you're actually working on your project. Now go ahead and grab a piece of bias tape. And this is what we're going to do next. Go ahead and grab one side of the seam allowance and place it like so. Then grab your bias tape and open it up. And place the edge of the bias tape on the edge of the seam allowance. And the next thing that we're going to do, we're actually going to stitch it together right into that crease of the bias tape. Now, once that is done, all you have to do is flip the bias tape over and top stitch on the edge of the bias tape, catching both sides, the front and the back. And that's it. Complete exactly the same steps on the other side of the seam allowance, press them open, and you have this beautiful finish done. Okay, it's time. Let's talk about French seams. Now, French seams are a favorite of many, many people, and they're exceptionally great for working with lightweight fabrics because not only they enclose the raw edge, completely preventing any fraying, they're actually quite durable, and if your fabric is somewhat see-through, the seam allowance is almost invisible, so it really is a great option for those type of garments and for those types of fabric. It is also one of the seams that is sewn by placing your fabric wrong sides together instead of right sides together. So grab your practice fabric, place it wrong sides together, and let's go ahead and sew a French seam. I take half an inch of seam allowance for completing a French seam, but you're going to start stitching at quarter of an inch with your fabric wrong sides together. Once that is done, go ahead and trim that quarter of an inch seam allowance to about 1/8 of an inch seam allowance, so just about in half. Now this is the right side of the fabric. Now we're going to go ahead and flip it open like so and give it a really good press. Now pressing between each step definitely makes a really big difference, so try to not to skip these steps. Next, we're going to sandwich the raw edge between the right sides of the fabric like so. And now we're going to give another really good press, just like you see me do on a screen. Now, once that is done, the last and final step, and you can see here the raw edges are going to be sandwiched between two layers of fabric. And the final step here is to stitch at 1/4 inch seam allowance, just like you see me do on a screen. And that's it. Once done, you will see a beautiful, neat finish on the right side of the fabric and a beautiful enclosed seam allowance on the wrong side of the fabric. So now we have a zigzag seam, bias bound seam, and a French seam. So let's take a look at what's next. And next we have faux or mock French seam, and it looks somewhat the same when it's done, but it's actually constructed in a completely different way. So let's go ahead and grab our muslin fabric, and we're going to be placing it right sides together and sewing at a 1/2 inch seam allowance, just like you would do on any other regular seam. Alright, this is how it looks when the seam is done. Now let's go ahead and pop it open, and we're actually going to press open the seam allowance right over here. So give it a really good press. Again, don't skip this step. And here's the interesting part. You know how the bias tape is folded with the raw edges to the middle? That's exactly the way we're going to fold the seam allowance, with the raw edges to the middle of it. So pretty much you're folding the seam allowance in half with both edges facing each other in the middle. Now, once that is done, the next step for us is to actually close the seam allowance and then stitch right on the edge of this seam allowance, enclosing the raw edges on the inside. And once done, this is how it looks. It looks very similar to the French seam. However, as you just saw, it is constructed in a completely different manner. Now, let's take a look at the actual French seam and the difference between these two. So you can clearly see that this is the French seam, and you can see the difference, how it looks, and the construction as well. Just a quick reminder that if you are a member of this channel, which is a paid function, first of all, thank you so much from the bottom of my heart. And I also wanted to let you know that you have these same worksheets available as a perk for being a member. So definitely check out the perks that you have as a member, because you have these available, so that way you can sew your own samples and have these two sheets as a reference for future projects. And the last seam on my list is flat felt seam. It is quite a durable one, and you will most often find it on shirts and denim. Now we will sew our fabric right sides together with 1/2 inch seam allowance. Once this is done, we're gonna go ahead and open the seam allowance. And the next step for us is to actually trim the seam allowance, but only one side. So here you see I'm trimming one side of the seam allowance to be about 1/8 inch wide. Once that is done, you can clearly see that one seam allowance is more narrow than the other. And here comes one of the last steps. Give it a really good press from this side, give it a really good press from the right side, and now what we need to do is we need to wrap the longer seam allowance around the shorter seam allowance, kind of like you would do with a bias tape, only instead of bias tape, you're using the seam allowance, and then give it a really good press so that way it would lay nice and flat and make it easier for you to sew. After that, it will look like so. And the next step is to actually flip the seam allowance towards the main fabric, like so, enclosing all of the raw edges. And now we're going to give it a straight stitch on the very edge of that seam allowance. Once that is done, from the right side of the fabric, you're going to see one seam, and from the wrong side of the fabric, you're going to see two parallel seams, just like this. Now, I did promise a video about seam allowances, so if you want to know more about that, go ahead and click on the screen right here, and I will see you there. Thank you. Bye.